So we're into the proper closing stages of Rio 2016. Just one game left for Poland and Germany, and it is the battle to be on the podium at the medal ceremony with a bronze medal draped around their neck. And here's a look at the teams.
Poland have a number of injury problems. Mikhail Jurecki, we're told, had a scan on his ankle yesterday and won't play. Is that gamesmanship? We'll see. Right back, Lijewski has a groin strain. And line player Sipsak, shoulder pain, but both will play, we're told. Left-back Bielecki, though, is the competition's top scorer. For Germany, they have two of the best wingers in the competition, Gensheimer and Reichmann, while at left-back, Kuhn has been very impressive and may well start at the back alongside Drucks and Hefner, while Wolf has been favoured in goal, despite the fact that Heinevetter seems to have slightly the best stats, but, of course, over less games played. So the team's on the bench now, and there's Talent Dujcebaev, took over the squad since the European Championships when Poland, unfortunately, disappointed on home soil, while his counterpart Dagur Sigurdsson, the Icelander in charge of Germany, former Icelandic international player, with the goggles there to protect the eye he lost some time ago, 2010, in an accident playing handball. Karel Bielecki, competition's top scorer with 52 goals, but he is up against one of the best wingers in the business, Uwe Gensheimer, 43 goals, an enviable success rate with his shooting, 81%. So teams are preparing here, and it'll be interesting to see if the Germans do go for slightly deeper defence, maybe a 5-1 even, to try and counter the crosses on the right to bring Bielecki into the shooting position. They do at least have in Lemke at 2m10 the right player to mark the towering line player Sipsak.
So there is Andreas Wolf, who will start in goal for the Germans. And it'll be Poland to get us underway. The bronze medal match at Rio 2016 begins. The crowd are on their feet, cheering on their team. The German fans just up at the top of the screen there. Their side playing in black from right to left. The Poles in the white playing from left to right. 30 minutes first half, 30 minutes second half. If they can't be separated, we go into 2x5 minutes of extra time. Potentially another 2x5 minutes of extra time after that. And then it comes to penalties. Here we go then, into the area, trying to wrestle in straight away was Lijewski, but it was well blocked.
So Poland start with Krajewski in the centre in place of Jurkiewicz. No surprise on the backs though, Lijewski and Bielecki. Another good block by Germany, who've opted for 6-0 defence, waiting to see what happens with Bielecki. But for now, Dujcebaev halfway between happy and frustrated by the looks of that, as Daszek goes in on the line, one of the best wingers in the competition, although today up against two of the great artisans of the game as well on the wing, as Bielecki is brought down. And here's the foul again. Pekela, the huge line player, 2m3, blocking him with Vida. He resumes with passive play, being warned. 6 passes allowed, straight through, fouled in the act of shooting as he broke in. And that's going to be the first penalty of the game. Lijewski awarded it. Windmill feint to get past Lemke, who just made absolutely no connection other than to slap him on the way past and bring him down and give away the 7-meter.
So the chance for the first goal in the bronze medal match, and it's going to be Bielecki. And he scores another goal for Bielecki in this tournament. That is his 53rd of the campaign and his 20th from the 7-meter line.
Unlucky for Wolf, who got a touch on it, but not enough. Straight over the head of the keeper, last place he can get his hands to. So, Poles, for their part, have started with a 5-0-1 defence, almost, it looks like. Jachlewski, the winger, has pushed up, and he's right in front of Hefner. A right back normally, but often used in the central position. In fact, it is a 5-1. He's staying in the middle, trying to disrupt the build-up. The Germans, who like plenty of crossovers at the back, they pull the defence one way, switch the ball back the other way. Here's the action again. Little body check for the 9-meter. And they're laying their stall out early, the Poles, with very aggressive and early defence. It's just what they need. It skims past the goal of Wyszomirski, who started ahead of Zmal. Attacking foul. Krajewski straight in, and Gensheimer, who is so quick on the break, but they know it, and Wyszomirski came out and cut the long pass.
Very effective stuff by the Poland goalkeeper. Read that one very, very well. You can see Pekela spotted Gensheimer, and Gensheimer had no idea the goalkeeper was coming. And there was the attacking foul by Krajewski. Poland 1, Germany 0 as we approach 3 minutes in this first half. This is the bronze medal match here at Rio 2016. And Poland coming forward again, inside to Lijewski. A couple of overlaps here and there, but he decides to keep the ball and is fouled. Always animated on the touchline, isn't he?
He never stops. You won't see him sit down. Bielecki for the moment then has got Vida in front of him, who's not the tallest of the defenders. Oh, dearie me. And Druk's quick nod to the referee, saying, really wasn't my fault. I was just a bit over-exuberant. Oh, dear. He's trying to come out from the wing at the back. They're trying to put a faster defender onto Bielecki at the moment, the Germans. But as he comes to the middle, and of course, he comes up against Lemke. Ah, breakthrough. And it's down the middle at the moment for Poland. Krajewski again breaking through. It's where they won the last penalty as well. Bielecki drawing the attention. Hard work on the line by Daszek, who just come around from the wing, and an awkward bounce for Wolf.
2-0. Paul Druk's got a yellow card in that build-up there. But it's Poland 2, Germany 0 now. As Poland looks to now defend against the German attack. They've only really had one effort at goal, that long effort, and oh, there's Druk into the bottom right, and Germany off the mark. Poland 2, Germany 1.
Well, the Poles need to bring in their fast players, doing it very well here against a very open German defence. Lijewski, Krajewski, the centre player, will need to move back into the centre. Lijewski tries his luck, but the rebound comes out kindly. Jaklewski's got it, and they take their time to move the ball around again, and Wolf. Good reactions there. And it's Bartosz Jurecki, who's been favoured ahead of Sipsak, who we understand has a bit of a shoulder injury. And maybe used sparingly, the Barcelona line player. Different build altogether. He's 2.08 meters. Because the German team are very tall. In fact, the tallest in the competition, averaging 1.96 meters. As Wolf saves, and the break is on. Oh, could have gone down the middle. Instead, moves right where he sees two spare players, and Vida overlaps. Scores his first of the game, and it's all square again. 5 minutes played.
So Poland 2, Germany 2. Henrik Pekela and Kai Hafner also got a yellow card in that incident a couple of minutes ago, which gave Poland a goal. So three yellow cards now for Germany. So here now come the Poles again. 5.5 minutes into the match. Little dart inside, but then a little bit too much into the ground there by Krajewski.
He got no power on the shot whatsoever. The Germans, as soon as Bartosz Jurecki comes out and goes around, they push up straight away to 9 meters. It's a very interactive defense. They're constantly moving up and back again, up and back. It's going to be tiring to do the whole match, but it makes sure that if Bielecki or Lijewski start to run, they're right there in front of them. On the wing, Gensheimer's outside the 9 meter line waiting. Daszek's trying to take close, but we've got a steal. Oh! Well, will that come back to haunt him later? Jaklewski on his own. And Wolf doesn't even have to do anything. He sails it over the crossbar.
Frustration for Jaklewski, who did so well to steal that in the first place. 11 goals in the tournament so far, but just steamed on towards the goal. Maybe could have done with just slowing his running a little bit. There was no one anywhere near him, and just compose himself a little more.
And he scored 7 from 8 fast breaks in the competition. He's been very reliable on this occasion. Oh, good save! Wiesomierski, a touch on it. And he's frustrated because as the ball goes out, no one picks up. And it's a throw-in for Germany. Get another chance, makes another save. Not such a good shot, that down the middle. Poland break. Daszek, as ever, shoots up ahead, and that's an attacking foul. Clever play by Wieńczek. End-to-end stuff here. Oh, and Wiesomierski had moved up and got himself caught out. He was running back desperately, but Reichmann gets there and slams it away before he can get himself composed in goal.
So Germany into the lead for the first time in the match. There was the attacking foul from Lijewski. You can see the goalkeeper trying to recover, but it was Tobias Reichmann down the right wing who managed to slot it past the goalkeeper. Poland 2, Germany 3 then. 7 minutes and 18 seconds gone in this 30-minute first half. This the battle for the bronze medal.
A little slip there by the referees because they were waiting to blow the restart, and they did. But actually, they already had a couple of players down in amongst the German defence, maybe not paying attention unless it was a stop-start. But Reichmann, scorer of the last goal, one of the big beneficiaries from the injury, Goretzky, was injured for the European Championships and has established himself since. But Bielecki, long-range effort, and he's finding his arm, and that's good news for the Poles.
Tobias Wolf not quite able, Andreas Wolf, sorry, not quite able to keep it out. And here's another break for Poland, then another goal for Poland. Hurdles into the back of the net, and it's Krajewski who finds the back of the net this time. Poland 4, Germany 3. Very, very quick turnaround for Poland. Again, possession lost as they tried to get it into Wieńczek. And no mistake made this time. And that is two goals in 20 seconds for Poland to come from behind to now lead.
Well, three fast breaks shown there. Two of them scored between the two teams. I think that's not being too generous. There's been a lot more than that. Wieńczek! Oh, the defender moved up and just gifted that one. Wieńczek couldn't quite believe his luck.
Poland 4, Germany 4. Now here come Poland forward again. Bielecki out there, number 8. Back inside to Krajewski. Then here in the right-back position, number 3, is Lijewski.
We've had 15 goals or 15 shots at goal already in about 8.5 minutes. It's certainly teeing itself up to be a nice fast game, but can they maintain this for 60 minutes? Drugs, in that respect, Germany probably have the deeper bench with the injury problems for Poland. Szyba being used extremely sparingly. Michał Jurecki evidently injured and unlikely to come on. And you wonder if the Poles simply haven't brought out extra players or enough extra players. They've changed one early in the competition. Gerek got injured. Jurkiewicz coming in, but they're likely to get tired faster than the Germans, who have a good turnover pace at the back and plenty of choice. Passive play being warned. It doesn't matter too much. Poor pass to the line there. Dribbles through, and the Germans are back quickly. And Reichmann, penalty. Foul in the act of shooting. And I'm afraid that Jaklewski is in trouble with the refs, grabbing the arm from behind. And Reichmann, who ironically plays for the Polish champions Kielce, is the man who wins the penalty for the Germans. And so off goes Jaklewski. There's the foul, jumping into him in midair.
Another chance for Gensheimer from the 7-meter line. He's scored 17 so far in the competition from here. Oh, cool as you like from Uwe Gensheimer. Germany in the lead, Poland 4, Germany 5. Look at this.
He makes him commit, lifts his leg, and he just bounces with a bit of spin around the other side. So power play for the Germans, but the Poles respond by taking out the goalkeeper to keep it at full strength in attack. It's a change in the centre where Jurkiewicz has now replaced Krajewski.
10 minutes gone, Poland 4, Germany 5, as Poland now try and get back on level terms again. Thought about the long shot, tried to feed it in, and it bounces wide, but the penalty is given. Looks as though the referee's going to his pocket as well. It was Jurecki who was brought down as he tried to shoot, had only just about managed to get a clear look on goal.
Yellow card for Lemke as Bartosz Jurecki does the sub, and Bielecki steps up to take a penalty to level the scores once more. Wolf moves up as far as he's allowed, and the same thing, lifts his right leg, and as he does so, see it here, plants it down next to the standing leg.
Five all then, as we approach 11 minutes. Hefner, out to Vida. Vida fires it in, and it's put home. And it's Julius Kühn with his first goal of the game. The man who was so impressive in the semi-final match, Julius Kühn.
Short-handed Polish defence. They're struggling to plug all the gaps, and Kühn, one of the fastest players in the business, coming in from the back, scored 8 from 9 in their semi-final. Still, though, ending up on the losing side against France as the Poles short-handed take out the goalkeeper. Daszek is going to go in on the line to try and create some space for Lijewski, or indeed Bielecki, but he's the wrong side at the moment. Bielecki stranded on the right. Daszek comes back in again. Oh, coolly done. Well, well, well. The opportunity right there to put it under the keeper. Sails past the face of the goal. And two good chances for Poland so far in this game that they're going to look back on a fast break, and that where the angle was huge and Wolf really committed. Where if they lose this by goal, it lapses of attention.
So still Poland 5, Germany 5. That shot from Kuhn was given as a goal on the official scoring, but has now been given as a miss. So it must have rattled the side netting. Looked to me as though it had gone in, but there's people with better eyes than me at the moment, as we are 12 minutes into the match. Poland 5, Germany 5. And now forward come Poland once more. On again has come Jurecki to go and play in the line. Not in any rush at the moment, Poland. Happy to just settle and build up the attack.
Yeah, they're probably not as quick a team as the Germans. They're quick on the phase one, fast break, certainly with the likes of Daszek, Wiśniewski and Jachlewski on the wings, but if that doesn't work, it's right that they should slow it down. The Germans are the ones who've got pace throughout, and they mustn't let them control the pace of this game. But Kuhn, not only dangerous in attack, but in defence, he gets out quick and makes sure that Lijewski simply can't release the ball in, and Bienczek behind gets in the way of the pass. No service for Jurecki. 13 minutes played, the clock's been stopped, a bit of mopping required, and we can now resume. Bartosz Jurecki still playing on the line instead of Sipsak. Maybe saving him up for the second half. Bielecki, he is a danger, but you can see how he comes in relatively slowly, and the Germans are up very quickly to mark him. There's no option to pass to the line. Oh, brilliant! Little Kempe. Well, why not? It's a medal match. Showboating is de rigueur, and the goal goes in off Jachlewski.
Poland 6, Germany 5. Attacking foul given there against Drugs, I think it was. Kuhn it was, who tried to barge his way in, and the fast break was on there for Poland. Now they're coming up a little bit more quietly, and they find the back of the net anyway. Jurecki was up there calling for the ball, but Poland took their time, managed to find Krajewski, who spun it under the keeper and found the back of the net.
That was nicely played, the gap opening up. And the end defender stuck between, do I mark the back player, do I stay with the winger who's dangerous? It was coolly done by Krajewski.
It's a two-goal margin now for Poland. Germany having conceded possession a couple more times. And here comes Drux tumbling in, but the chance is still there. Hits the base of the post. I think it was Hefner who had the shot, and now here's the fast break right up the other end. And another goal for Poland, and it's Michał Daszek with his first goal of the game. Poland 8, Germany 5.
A three-goal run for Poland. 5-5 has become 8-5 to Poland. Daszek scoring the last of the fast breaks there, and Wiśniewski very happy with that. Team timeout's been called meanwhile as the Germans reel from that quick exchange.
So Geduld. Wir stehen sehr lange und da muss man konsequent bis zum Schluss. Guter Abschluss vorne, so dass wir zuerst zurückkommen. Los geht's, komm! Ja, okay. Wir haben drüber gesprochen, über das 1-1.
So he's looking Sigurdsson there.
Später. Wir machen es weiter, wir machen die Müde. Spät! Voll!
Albo idź pod zasłoną. W ataku zaczynasz krzyżować i długi zasłony.
See these great shots from the match so far, and the crowd are getting into this. Play resumes then after the team timeout for Germany, who've just conceded three goals in 1 minute and 15 seconds to completely lose the initiative. That's how fast it can go wrong for you. this very open defence by the Poles. They've got to run at it, they've got to get in behind. Hefner goes there first, they've got the players to do it, and that's a penalty. Taking them on one-on-one, that was a good change. Weinhold, industrious as ever, goes in and challenges Kuss, who has been slightly slow in defence. He's a big lad, but not necessarily the quickest. And as we reach the midway point in the first half, Gensheimer with a chance to stem the Polish tide.
Again, just cool as you like from Uwe Gensheimer.
Heiner Brandt there, the former coach of the German team who took to them the world title in 2007. He approves of that. A little applause, very polite.
So Poland 8, Germany 6. And we are into the second half of this first half now. Both sides have converted both of their 7-metre shots. Poland now start to build.
Oh, good save. Wolf got down very quickly to his left. Saves off Krajewski, who scored three already in Germany. As ever, very quick as they come back. Looking to get in behind. Slightly shallow defence. Oh, nearly stole the ball. Drucks reacts quickly, though. Sneaks up and gets it. And briefly there, Jachlewski thought he could race onto it. And for the moment, the Poles will be pleased that they've managed to contain the German captain Gensheimer to just two penalties in the game. He's waiting wide, but his role isn't necessarily always to score. It's to pull the defence wide by standing right in the corner. Long-range shot, that's not going to trouble him too much. Wyszomierski playing well, they've just kept it in play. Wieńczek harassing them there, nearly stealing it back as Kuss, the defence specialist, goes off together with Jurkiewicz. Wyszomierski's had a brilliant start to the game. Over for a quick chat with the captain. Well, he's done his bit to keep them in front here. And the save rate, 45% for Wyszomierski, 38 for Wolf.
So now Poland looks to come forward again with Bielecki out on the left.
And some changes now. They're trying to keep the initiative, but with the changes, Schreiber has come on. He didn't play at all in the semi-final, of course, at all. Sipsak is back there, the Barcelona line player. Oh, straight down the middle. Well, it was almost like he shot an arrow through the centre of the court. Drucks picked the ball up, ran like an eye. Look at him. Give me the ball back, please. I'm going down. Tallest player is in front of him, but he shoots low, beats him, and beats Wyszomierski. Nicely done.
So, the Germans have brought it back from 8-5 down to 8-7 down. They're starting to get back into this a little bit. Here come Poland. Out to Schreiber. And the foul. First time we're really getting to see Schreiber, as you mentioned. Bielecki.
Also, they've got on the wing Wiśniewski. It's interesting, they do a 3-0 exchange to take the lead. And then Dujczybaev changes three players, and it's kind of thrown the rhythm. There's one of them, Wiśniewski's just come on, no reflection on them, but the others win their stride. It's a strange decision. Now a chance on the wing. Oh, yes. And Gensheimer, his first goal from open play, his third in total, and now it's Germany on a 3-0 run.
Now look at this pass from, I think it was Lemke. He goes over, and just as he's falling, rolls the ball behind him, knowing that Gensheimer's going to be out there. And Gensheimer makes no mistake at all, firing it into the back of the net. So Germany have completed the comeback. 8 goals all with 12 minutes to go. 11 and a half to go, if you want to be really precise, in this first half. Bielecki plays it square. Dummied the low shot, and Wolf just about saved it, but the penalty's given anyway.
Wieńczek concedes it there, but the save by Wolf was spectacularly good. He was going the wrong way, somehow checked himself, but all to no avail, sadly, as Wieńczek bustles Krajewski over, and Bielecki will take the penalty, but the clock is stopped. Wolf will go off, and Silvio Heinewetter, the Fuchs Berlin goalkeeper, comes on. He's only saved 1 from 8. Wolf has saved 8 penalties in the competition, but why not try him? He's got the best save rate so far, 41%. Flamboyant keeper. Is he going to go forwards or sit back? He goes right up to the 4-meter line. Oh, he saved it! Oh, yes, and he goes boom! Bielecki goes for power, straight onto the arm. That's a poor penalty by him, but Heinewetter absolutely chuffed.
So it remains 8-all. First missed 7-meter penalty of the match. by either side. And it's Bielecki who misses it, the competition's top scorer. And now Germany with the chance to take the lead in what has been a really entertaining first 20 minutes. Little cut inside from Weinhold. Here comes Drux. Very, very nicely done. Beautifully held himself in the air, and then without much power, it was all about precision, that shot.
But again, Kuss, he's sitting back. He's torn between Mark and Pekela. There should be better talking between him and Jurkiewicz to mark the line.
Poland 8, Germany 9. So we saw a big old swing. It went from 5-all to 8-5 to Poland. And now it's gone from 8-5 to Poland to 9-8 to Germany. Real battle of momentum almost.
Well, Deutsche Bayer will be looking on and saying, well, I made those three changes. Sheba, Sipchak and Wisniewski, just when we had the initiative, have I got it wrong? Wolf, meanwhile, is returning goal despite Heinenvetter's penalty save. Gets back into the swing of things as... now another change at the back. Bielecki has gone off. And so Sheba plays on the right. Jurkiewicz at left back, not unusual for him, the Kielce man. Wisniewski, who'd gone in as an extra line player, is brought to the ground, and that's a two-minute suspension. And the referee's waiting to see if there was an advantage for the Poles before sending Lemke off, and a polite handshake from him for the player on the way. And it was in the back that the foul was happening. Lemke off then. It's a power play for Poland.
Second two-minute suspension of the match for either side. And Poland looking to take an advantage here, or rather pull themselves back level with Bielecki inside to Jurkiewicz. Here he is again, Jurkiewicz, out to Bielecki. Little dummied slow shot, but there's the attacking foul, and Weinhold would just stood stationary, really, and Krajewski piled into him.
Bartosz Jurecki on the right, who's put the block on for him, is going, why didn't you not just step in? I've given you a two-meter-wide gap, and you go straight into the defender on the other side. Weinhold probably can't quite believe his luck that he could stand there and take the foul. And that's the fifth turnover for Poland. And little niggling problems with the Polish attack sometimes, too direct. Germans, on the other hand, have got nice mobility. And they've certainly got the players to break down a deep defence. Kuss trying to mark the line. They've got to talk properly this time. And again, Weinhold finds a little bit of space on the right-hand side, just enough, and gets the shot away. And Germany now with a two-goal lead.
Poland 8, Germany 10. 8 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock in this first half. In a very evenly fought contest. And it's out to Lijewski, back inside, into the line. Whistle goes as...
Bartosz Jurecki back on his feet again, and the Poles have got to spread this wide. They've got the extra players. The defence is crowding the centre, and they're still trying to batter down the middle. Bartosz Jurecki, whose brother Michał Jurecki on the bench is, we're told, won't play, but you never know with Deutsche Bayer if that's not a bit of gamesmanship for the Germans to hear. And here we go again, and Bielecki is back on, and immediately it pays dividends. They push up onto him. And Bartosz Jurecki uses the space at the back to get his goal. Pekela hopelessly out of position with a big gap to mark, of course, on the power play. Bartosz Jurecki not being used in defence. Kuss back in the centre. He's strong, but has got himself caught out a few times. 8 two-minute suspensions in the competition so far. Sometimes a little too direct for the referee's liking. Pekela out and drops back in again. Wieńczek going around the outside. That's an attacking foul. Drux rather clumsily picking the spot with three defenders.
Fortunately, Germany had just returned to full strength, so Andreas Wolf had just returned into goal. There is Drux charging into Jurkiewicz and Krajewski as well. And that's the attacking foul going the way then of Poland, and they will starts to come forward again. But the referee just having a little conversation with Drux.
That's why that last shoulder barge we saw in slow motion has sent Jurkiewicz down. The last thing Poland need right now is another injury problem. He's holding his shoulders, he gets up. Drux still speaking to the referee and saying, well, look, it was just a fair challenge, unfortunate. But they will restart the play then with Wiśromirski moving the ball down from where they stopped the play just to check on him. And chopping and changing on the line, Dujce Baev. He's got Sipsak back on again, the number 23. 2 meters and 8 tall, 116 kilos. Though he is up against Lemke, the central defender, 2 meters and 10, 115 kilos. He can match him in every counter, in fact, outdo him as that shot clips off the post and nearly went off the back of Wolf, who arched himself forwards to miss it. And back come Germany on the break. Dummies to the wing, but should have passed it straight away because it's an attacking foul by Weinhold. And it remains 10-9 in an evenly matched encounter. Dummied it, but ran straight into Wiśniewski.
So Weinhold trying to charge in. Unable to do so on that particular occasion for the number 17 for Germany, making his 92nd appearance for his country. But he came in late into this tournament, missed the first two matches. He was brought in as a replacement. But since then, he has shown why he is an experienced member of the German side, albeit not in the starting seven that often, but when he does come on, he is very effective. Here come Poland now to try and get level again.
The Germans pushing Wieńczek up now at the front as Bielecki comes right across court, as he often does, into the wing. No space there, that's quick play now as they try and unlock the wing. Looking for the line, fails completely, and the break is off. Reichmann up court, way ahead of the defender, and scores. And Germany take a two-goal lead again, courtesy of the winger. Well, take your pick, Gensheimer and Reichmann, both so quick, and he's off like a rocket. You can see him there, and the defender already 3 meters behind at the halfway line.
So another goal for Tobias Reichmann. What were Poland trying to do with that? Was it trying to get into the line play?
He was trying to get into the line play, but I think with all the resin on their hands, sometimes the ball just leaves either that bit too early or a bit too late. On that occasion, I think it rolled out too early, and it ballooned as we see this amazing jump. He hangs and waits for the goalkeeper to commit himself. And that goal has given them a little bit of a cushion. It's their second fast break goal, although they've had a few phase two goals, which are not as direct, but still against a defense that's falling back and not fully in order yet. They would still be classified technically as a fast break. Looking for the line, straight into the feet, I thought, of Wieńczek, but they say he stole it fairly. Oh, cheeky! He couldn't resist it, Reichmann, he never can. Drops the ball with a reverse spin, and that's not easy to do. There's the steal. It was off his feet, wasn't it?
Yeah, off both of them, in fact.
That's Reichmann, amazing.
Take nothing away from Reichmann's finish, but it was none of the Polish players seemed to protest it.
Well, it may just be that the angle still did belie the fact there was a hand down there. He was reaching down into the line. Still with Poland, though. Daszek has it. They've got two on the line now. Oh! Drucks sends Bartosz Jurecki flying as they try this 4-2 formation. And surely now, as Germany are ploughing in there, and that's a rather agricultural challenge by Drucks that sees him take the long walk. Saw the referee let the other one go and thought, well, I'll keep going with the same style. But this time, finally, the Czech referees react.
2 minute suspension then for Paul Drucks as he makes his way off the court, the 21-year-old. And there's less than 5 minutes to go in this first half, and Germany have a three-goal margin. But we've seen so many times in this first 25 minutes almost how irrelevant a three-goal margin is, because teams can get back into it so quickly, and that's the way to start it off. Bartosz Jurecki firing it in off the underside of the bar, had so much room in that stretched German defence, and Bielecki just had to pick him out, and there was no one anywhere near him. Reichmann was having to try and cover the wing as well, and it's 10-12 now. Germany coming forward, and they have taken out the goalkeeper, so they're playing with all six players pushing up while they are down to six. Strobel has come on as well, sorry.
So Strobel on, as you say, two on the line now, try and flatten the back a little. Oh, beautifully played. It worked to perfection. And Weinhold able to follow in behind the extra line player. See the drive here. and it just diverted the defender's attention enough, and unfortunately Kuz probably not the right man up front. He's not quick enough. Weinhold goes straight around him with a quick step.
Gap back up to 10. Poland, back to 3, I should say. Poland 10, Germany 13. Oh, Lijewski trying to hang in the air and get it in. Whistle goes as Sipchak was brought down.
Sometimes that hesitation on the shot from the back isn't good. You know, they're looking for the line instead. He's so big, they think he'll do the job. But good defending by Germany. Look at it here. Lijewski hesitating. He was under big pressure. But the defence, you could say, had his foot right inside the area. But Nikos Sipchak really hadn't managed to push up to the six-metre line. Got the benefit of the doubt, and it's only a free throw. Weinhold a little relieved, but it happens all the time. And you've got to be right up there taking the shot in front of goal if you're going to win that penalty. Bartosz Jurecki starts at left back, but the line player goes in on the line. That's off a defender. Need to be a throw-in from the corner as Daszek retrieves the ball. And once more, Kuhn, the man who gets in the way. 1.98 meter. They've got a huge defence in the middle, the Germans. They're all between 1.98 and 2.10 meters. It's a rather daunting task for the Poles looking at this, even for Bielecki. And here's 2.02 meters. Another free throw as they manage to keep the defenders in front, and we're now into the last 3 minutes. The FC, who's really struggled to have any say in the game. Oh, tried to bounce the ball, and Wisniewski came out, missed the connection. And Gensheimer almost walks it into the goal. Tried to bounce it, great steal.
And amazing how fast Gensheimer got up. Considering they're down to six, he would have been back defending at that point. And he just, one blink and he's halfway up the court.
The wingers are loitering at 9 meters. He is all the time, if you look in attack with Gensheimer. But even now, he will be right up on the 9 meter line. As soon as the ball is in the halfway area and across the other side, he's waiting, ready to go. So back they come again. Now a 4-goal lead for Germany, slowly but surely asserting themselves on this. And that, the first long-range effort for Lijewski, and some relief for him. We need a lot more of that, though, from him. They're going to bring the gap back.
Oh, rattled in by Lemke Wieńczek, trying to get it. But the whistle goes. It'll be a free throw to Germany, and that's all.
Well, he had no control over the ball. He was diving in for it, and therefore they could only give the free throw, taking that as a 50-50. There's the initial shot. Polish defence having gone flat on this occasion, allowing the Germans to make the crossovers, and both players diving for it. But clearly Kuz slapping across Wieńczek. Inside the last 2 minutes then, as the mopping goes on. And the Poles need a little bit deeper in defence, because the crossovers of Germany like that get the pace going on the attack are building up again. The problem for them is as they push up with Kuz, it's not been working. They've changed him now, Jurkiewicz. Tad more mobile, working alongside Sipchak to see if that can break it down. Into the wing, there's no space there. Eichmann wisely brings it back out again, and they try again. They've got two on the line now to flatten the defence. And it works. Kuhn.
Oh, straight up the other end. What a counter-attack there. And it's Wisniewski who finds the back of the net. So just as I was about to say, the gap extends to 4. The gap's back down to 3. Sipchak took it quickly. And there was no stopping Wisniewski there. Firing it into the back of the net. Here comes Germany again. Final minute of the match, of the half approaching. And it's Germany who are going to get an effort off here. But Poland should have another opportunity, depending on what happens with a minute left. Here comes Weinhold. Little bounce into Kuhn.
Going sideways at the moment, the arm's going to go up soon. Oh, doesn't need to, because again, Kuhn, who was so lethal in the semi-final, gets his third goal. The man from Gummersbach, who's got 161 goals in the Bundesliga this season, shows why. 30 seconds to go then. Poland looking to retrieve one late here. They'll probably try and do that as late as they can, not to allow the Germans to come back at them. But still, they will go in trailing. Little handoff, and he's found his range. Lijewski, two quick goals for Poland. They'll race back. There's time now for Germany, a quick one. into the wing, he'll try it, Reichmann, yes, over the shoulder of the keeper with 3 seconds remaining. And the 4-goal lead restored by Reichmann in dramatic circumstances here. Lovely effort, straight at the keeper, couldn't open the angle because of the speed he was running in at. And shot the only place he really could, at Wyszomirski's face.
Well, what a dramatic and fast-paced opening half. A late goal from Reichmann means that it's Germany who have a 4-goal advantage at the break. Half-time in the men's handball bronze medal match here. And it is Poland 13, Germany 17. Germany get the second half of the bronze medal match underway. They're leading by 4 goals at the break, and they are attacking from left to right. But that 4-goal lead belies a very tight first half.
It does, and we've seen how quickly fortunes can change. But Poland do need to get stuck in quickly here and just stem the tide from the Germans. That'll help. Great save by Wyszomirski off a wicked shot, and they come out quickly. And at the back is Jurkiewicz, and swapping around in the central role with Krajewski, and off goes the defence specialist Kuss. Both teams making their substitutions. And back in comes the towering figure of Lemke, keeping an eye out for the two strong back players for Poland, although Lijewski coming good towards the end of the first half. Hopefully he can keep that run going. Here he comes. And of course Bielecki, the known danger on the left side. Oh, nearly got himself stranded, a balloon pass which almost tempted Weinhold to come out for it. Bielecki again, two defenders are straight in front of him, but it leaves space for Lijewski following in behind. And that was nicely worked, and Lijewski has effectively scored 3 goals in about 7 minutes either side of the break.
So they get back down to 3, Poland 14, Germany 17, and now it's Germany who will come forward onto the court in the centre there. Comes Reichmann there on the wing, and back inside to, it is Strobel who's come on in the centre-back position. Weinhold here at right back, and then in at left back again is Drux. He drives in, Wieńczek just about manages to keep possession, but the whistle had already gone for the foul.
So the Germans looking to drive in courtesy of Drux, who made such a name for himself at the World Championships in Qatar, but then was injured and missed out on the European campaign earlier this year when the team took silver. The Poles, for their part, 7 of their players come from the Champions Club Kielce, who of course won the Champions League this season. Great achievement, first time. Means there's good unity, and that's nothing given by the referee. He dived around the back of the defender, and Weinhold may feel a little hard done by. Into the line, he's over, it won't count, and Kuss comes away empty-handed. He is a line player by trade, but used as a defense specialist only here. Turns and there's his foot on the line. So a chance wasted by Poland, and that's the 10th turnover of the game as the Poles push very deep in defense. They're trying to unsettle these crossovers that the Germans like to do. And Wieńczek waiting wide. He pulled off to the outside as the back player runs towards the middle. He goes the other way. And Drux finding a way back straight past the nose of Lijewski.
Beautifully picked up for Wieńczek. Still pretty low for him to get down to that, and managed to do it very comfortably. And now here come Poland. Bielecki fumbles it, but it's just about bounces back into Jurkiewicz's possession. Cuts inside, Bielecki. Little charge inside, making the space, but the foul is given as Lijewski tried to find his way through.
He ran out of options effectively. He'd driven in so far that passing back to Bielecki was going to be risky, and the line was covered. Sipsak going in there at this stage in the second half. And a good save, but it's gone out to the side. Poland will keep possession with the throw-in. Wolf staying nicely alert, the goalkeeper who plays for Wetzlar, 10th in the Bundesliga this year, but he's heading off to German powerhouse Kiel next season. Nice reaction off Bielecki. Rolf, who played an absolute grinder in the European Championship final earlier this year to win the title off Spain. Bielecki still not finding a way through. Frustration also for Dujčibaev on the bench. Comes a long way across. He's got to run all the way back, the right-hander, and Lievski has swapped places with him. And a good shove, and Lievski moves back into his position. The Poles, you have just two left-handers, Daszek and Lievski, in their lineup, and that's an attacking foul straight into the defender. Germany break, and briefly, Gensheimer was free on the line, should have got the ball back. Instead, the shot is taken. The ball is loose, but somehow Germany picked it back up again, fumbling all over the place, both teams. And Gensheimer was the player who was free on the line. Where was the ball picked up? Well, it's Gensheimer who raced out. He's so quick, and mopping required down the middle. Two teams who know each other well, of course, met in the competition here. They played in Qatar in the World Championships. Germany also won there, 29-26. In fact, the last Polish victory goes back to the World Championship qualifiers for 2015, when they won both home and away, knocked Germany out ostensibly. Germany were then given a lifeline and a wild card to come back in to the World Championships, where they finished seventh, and then on their way to qualification for the European Championships and that gold medal. Deep defence by the Poles, pushing up now. That's much better, although I'm not sure that that's a very conventional defensive play by the Polish players, heading the ball away. But it's a free throw anyway, because Druks was fouled. Jachlewski there. Oh, brilliant play. And Weinhold, windmill fend, gets around, goes into the middle, and Jurkiewicz, desperately trying to backtrack, gets a two-minute suspension. Charged into him.
Well, to get the shot in with that bigger hit through the legs of the goalkeeper, and that's what it means for Wieńczek, because it's now a five-goal margin for Germany. Poland 14, Germany 19. With 5.5 minutes gone in this 30-minute second half, and Poland down to six players, so they've taken off the goalkeeper, and all six players are in attack.
And a lot of mistakes by both sides so far in this half, just three goals in 5.5 minutes. The tide has been somewhat stemmed. That's going to be a free throw, the slap on Bielecki's arm. The tall player plays for Kielce. Had a while in Germany, played for Rhein-Neckar Löwen there. He'd been alongside the likes of Gensheimer. Gensheimer is moving on himself now from Rhein-Neckar Löwen. He's off to play at PSG in Paris. Oh, the defence on this occasion completely opens up. Miscommunication. And Krajewski finds space he couldn't quite believe. Switched back by Lievski. And Gensheimer having to choose between blocking that, or is he going to pass to the wing? Nope, he's going straight through.
So Poland's still down to six players. They've managed to get the gap back down to four for the moment. They're going to be down to six for the next 45 seconds, so Germany will try and take advantage. Weinhold out to the wing. And Reichmann's shot is saved, and Poland keep the ball in just about, I think. Whistle goes, no. Weren't quite able to do so. In came Reichmann, strong right arm. It looked as though Poland had just done enough. I think it was Jachlewski going in to try and save it. But it's still Germany with possession. 7 minutes gone.
So they build up again. They try and spread it wide while they've got the extra player. There we go again. Gensheimer tries again. Dummies the first shot. Shoots around the outside of Wieszomirski. Reichmann, rather. And Germany stretch the five-goal lead. But Weinhold again draws the centre. And Bielecki having to move out a little bit to help in defence and then race back. But Reichmann's too quick. Fourth goal for the winger, who ironically plays for Kielce. Bielecki's teammate there.
So Poland dropping further behind now. Five goals down to Germany in the preliminary stages. As Poland just try and find a little bit of space. It finished at 29-32. So just a three goal, and there's a good save by Wolf. And now away comes Reichmann again. Five for Reichmann. Well, Wolf made the save, and it was kind of straight at him, really. Moderately straightforward, but Jenček releases it, and away goes Reichman.
Well, a mistake, really. The Poles getting themselves all in a tangle in attack, and in the end taking a desperate shot, and as they tried to prevent the long pass, Bielecki's got himself sent off. Reichman still managing to get up court, but Wolf started the whole move. So, yet again, it's a power play, and the Poles have only just got back again. After Jurkiewicz served out a two-minute suspension, now have one for Bielecki. There he is. Frustrated. They've taken out the keeper to even up the odds. Sipsak is in on the line, and while he's off, Jurkiewicz has moved into the left-back position, and on is Krajewski in the central role. Lijewski. That's a penalty. Little shove in the air as he jumped through the gap. And some relief now for the Poles. Jurkiewicz, pushed by Weinhold, broke through quickly, and he was clear. So no Bielecki to take the penalty. He's on a suspension as the Germans bring on Heinevetter. Instead, up steps Krajewski. So he scores. Nice bounce shot. Another impassive-looking Poles, maybe feeling the gap isn't close enough to celebrate yet, but take nothing away from this penalty. Heinevetter commits himself very early, he knows it, and the ball just bounced down next to the standing leg.
So they get back up to five. Poland 16, Germany 21. 9 minutes gone in this second half. Weinhold. And again. Tries to feed it into the line. Pekela. Haven't seen much of Pekela in the match so far, but he has scored Germany's 22nd, Poland 16, Germany 22, and Pekela off the mark. Fires it past Fizomirski, and just about managed to keep himself outside of the area, and from then on it was a fairly straightforward effort. So gap up to six now between Poland and Germany in this bronze medal match, and it's been an even match, but it is Germany who are really starting to stamp their authority on it.
Poles running out of initiatives at the back. And maybe tiredness is kicking in. They've not got so many players to turn the bench, but they get one back there. Mateusz Jaszlewski, the Kielce winger, playing his second Olympics, and a penalty down the other end. And it's won by Pekela, who's been on mostly in the defensive role, with Jenček favoured in the attack, but he scored one goal and now wins this penalty. His arm clearly impeded as he tried to bring it up to shoot. And the clock's been stopped on the stroke of 10 minutes played in the second half, and Gensheimer steps up once more, and Schmal is gone in goal. Makes absolutely no difference to Gensheimer, the pass master at the 7 metre. Schmal tries to react, goes down as he often does on the penalty, and I think Gensheimer's fully aware of that. So the lead stretching now, 6 goals for Germany. Slowly but surely the gap is stretching, and no solutions at the back. And with the 2 minute suspension served out, Bielecki still not coming out as they stick with Jurkiewicz at the left back position. Jurkiewicz has had a lot of injuries this season with Kielce, not played a lot. An interesting choice for the Olympics as Sipsak scores, and Sipsak slips. Try saying that.
Now here comes Finn Lemke into Fabian Wieder. On the overlap, that's a good save. Will it come out to Wiencheck? No, it's palmed away, but it's a free throw to Germany. They wanted to just play on and keep it going. Is there any question of tiredness with Poland? They played later than Germany in their semi-final. The match finished, I think, about 10 o'clock at night, and it went to extra time. So they've played another 10 minutes for Germany than Germany more recently.
Undoubtedly, I mean, the recovery time is important, but still here, it's also a factor for the Poles that they don't turn as much at the back. They've tried to bring in Szyba, but it's not particularly effective, as we have a goal there, but an injury as well. And
it's Fabian Wieder.
Have a look and see the incident again. He tries to go in. Oh, slap in the face.
Oh, and then I think he banged his head on the way down.
There it is. Well, it's on the shoulder, and that's going to hurt anyway. And as you say, here we go. Well, in fact, no, he jerks his neck back as he tries to stop, but he's already taken a knock on the side of the face, and that seems to have knocked him somewhat senseless there. The clock has been stopped, and he may need to go off for some treatment. And for that last hack in defence, Sipsak has got himself a two-minute suspension as Sigurdsson tries to use the time to bellow some instructions across to his players. He's getting up rather gingerly, Vida. That was a hard impact, you could see. And just making sure he knows where he is. Doctor's looking on rather concerned, and they've got so much strength and depth at the back, it would make sense to take him off. And he hobbles, in fact, as well, with a limp. So it's all gone wrong for him. So he'll take his place on the bench under the new rules. He's got to miss the next three attacks, although it looks like he may need at least that to recover. Meanwhile, for Poland, trying to take the throw off again, and once more they are short-handed.
Is that rule to miss the next three attacks, is that to stop sort of feigning injury?
It's exactly that, and so many people do, especially in the latter stages of the game, and it has worked remarkably well. I have to say, it's one of the rule changes that there is no discussion about. The goalkeeper, I think the jury's out on that, with the option not to put the bib on the player. So Bielecki has now come back into the line, looks to feed the line, but there's so much pressure, and it's a break instead. And Reichmann hangs in the air forever and leaves absolutely no chance whatsoever to Wyszomierski. And Reichmann, six goals today. Look at that steal. Drucks straight down the court. He knows he's going to be there. He just lobs it. He runs onto it. And the good keeper left to his own devices there.
So seven goals the difference now between Poland and Germany. Poland 18, Germany 25. Another goal for Reichmann, who's still trying to G his team up. Poland still down to six players for the next minute. So the fight back for Poland needs to start pretty promptly. Just need to thwart a couple of German attacks and score some goals of their own. I say just. Obviously that's what they need to do. Jerkiewicz inside. Can't find any space, and Bienczek comes in heavily there. And is that going to be a two-minute suspension? Or is he going to get away with that one, Bienczek? Yes, it is. Two-minute suspension for Bienczek.
Not sure why they needed to have a little conference about that. The referees, you can see with the headsets, talking to each other and saying absolutely. Well, a sporting handshake. No ill intent. Bucibov thought for a moment it wasn't going to be given, but he is off. And now both teams are short-handed. But Poland, time is running out. They've really got to react here. They've still got Jurkiewicz now at the left-back position. Not to bring on Bielecki into the wing. There's a lot of space there. Oh, off the keeper. Wolf saves. Not only that, stays in play. And Daszek comes away empty-handed. Daszek, who's had such a great Olympic game, but here today really has been starved of passes. Only scored one from three.
Yeah, 30 goals in the game so far, but only one today.
It's also because the problem for them is they like the fast break, but with Reichmann and Gensheimer being two of the quickest wingers in the business, and of course he's up against Gensheimer on his side, he's been covered on a lot of the breaks he'd normally have. And Wieńczek, when he's been on in defence, has been very quick down the middle to cut the angle for a straight pass as well. Only once has he been beaten doing that. And Weinhold takes a shot, just goes wide, but comes off the hands of a defender. And a team timeout is called by Germany, who lead here by seven goals.
Nana, den Angriff. Langsam von hier bis hierhin. Ja, aber dann lass mal den Ball laufen. Ja, und gehen wir in die Aktionen. Wenn wir passiv werden, kriegen wir keine Freiwürfe. Wir müssen den Ball laufen lassen, die Hand bieten, in die Kreuzungen, zack, zack, zack. Schnell zurücklaufen, keine Gegenstoße. Wir sind hier vor, welche Schuss oder welche Schnitte. Und nicht dabei, denn wir kaschen, dass du das, was du da hast, was du da hast. Und nicht immer checken, was du da hast.
Well, visibly frustrated, Talan Duchibayev, who I thought might have been the one to call the team timeout, seven down instead. Well, that goes Sigurdsson, does him a favour. But all he can do is vent his frustration on the team by the looks of it at the moment as they're letting this match pull away from them. The play resumes then after the team timeout. Germany on the attack once more. They push up in defence, but the Germans have been going in behind the front defender and finding space. There's the reaction. They're pushing on the line.
What an effort that is. It rattles off the post from Julius Kühn. But so much power in his shots, Kühn. When you look at this German side, and OK, it may only be a bronze medal here, but the young talent they've got in there is impressive.
It's hugely impressive, and what a difficult choice for Sigurdsson, winning the European Championship with effectively a German B team with all the injuries and having to decide which of the B team youngsters do I keep and the old pros. But he seems to have got the balance right here as we see another save at the far end and Germany stream up. I mean, Reichmann, one of the big beneficiaries on the right wing, who ironically, of course, plays in Poland, where he scored 118 goals for them this season in the Polish league, but he's also scored 69 in the Champions League, including 9 in the final that they won to take their first title. But, today up against 7 of his club teammates and friends, and he's very much going to go back with the bragging rights. And that's another penalty, a little push, and I suspect we have a 2-minute suspension as the foul on Weinhold. He was through, and Bartosz Jurecki has a little argument with the referee. He's barging straight into him, and the referee standing just behind sends him off. And the 2-minute suspensions are coming with annoying regularity for Poland as Gensheimer steps up to the 7-meter line. No change of keeper this time. Wiszomirski. Oh, good save, and he stays in as well. Well, rarely does he miss. Dummied the first one. And Wiszomirski thought, well, I'll do exactly the same thing the second time, and it worked out.
So, is that the one lifeline Poland need to try and turn around and get some momentum in this match? They are 7 goals down. It's going to be a tough ask. They're a player down as well at the moment. So they've pushed everyone up. No goalkeeper in there for Poland. They cut inside. Lijewski. Jurkiewicz. Back again to Lijewski. It's so busy on the line there. There's no one out on the right wing, and they're trying to drive in more to find the penalty than anything else, and it's just a free throw.
So free throw, but passive play being called. Here's the shove to earn it, but they've got 6 passes now to get the next attack going. Oh, there's a chance. The defender falls, and straight through goes Jurkiewicz into the space, and again, Poland hanging on by the skin of their teeth here. There's the trip. In fact, it's Sipchak's foot that seems to catch Druks. Down he goes, and still, though, short-handed Poland.
So this is where Germany should be able to take advantage. Weinhold out to Reichmann. In again to Weinhold. Dummies the shot, then gets it out to the wing for Uwe Gensheimer. Just wide. So another chance now for Poland to come forward, maybe get the gap back down to 5. Oh, should be a good couple of minutes for them.
Urgency apparently seen there by Jachlewski, and 2 in quick succession. Jurkiewicz, player who came on for Gerek midway through the group stages, dummies the pass to the wing, goes straight down the middle. Pekler slow to move up onto him, and he scores. In fact, it was Lemke. 5 goals the deficit. Poland, though, are looking a little ragged. They're looking tired. Mustn't forget Lijewski, a bit of a groin strain, is playing not fully fit, the right back, but he's the only left-handed right back they have. The problems with the selection, maybe. Working hard, but not necessarily getting the results. Weinhold, 2 in on the line. Gensheimer went on the line, thinks about it for a while, again shoots wide. He was rather stranded, trying to get a pass back out from there was going to be difficult. Looking across, see if Reichmann was free, but very quickly they marked him. So the shots on goal now, about the same for the team, 58-59%. Oh, Wolf nearly falling out of the area with his ball. That would have been a turnover. And they have to just ease up a little as we've got players who've fallen in the front defender there. Will be Jachlewski once more. They've gone a bit flat in defence. The Poles, 12 minutes remaining in the bronze medal match. And for Germany, interestingly, Strobel has now gone in on the left wing in place of Gensheimer.
No goals in 6 minutes so far for Germany. Is that going to change? No, it's not. It's saved again by Wizimierski. So Poland it is with the momentum at the moment. Out wide, back inside. There's the low shot. It's well blocked. And then Germany just take their time. Poland 20, Germany 25. Just over 11 minutes to go. Another save for Andreas Wolf. There's the saves to shot on goal percentage again. Pretty similar between the two sets of goalkeepers.
It is interesting that Strobel has now replaced Gensheimer. He's a playmaker. Come left back. He's deep in the wing. Assume he's looking to come around unless Gensheimer has picked up a little knock. You wonder. That's going to be a free throw because Germany don't have any alternative wingers. Here's the incident. Drucks fouled by Lievski. But the Germans, who had two right wingers when they came out, but Gruetzki injured, was replaced. And Gensheimer, though, their only recognised left winger on the bench. Long-range shot, another save. Tried to pick up the loose ball, but all he does is skid over the back line with it. Krajewski, and it's a throw-in for the Germans from the corner, which will be taken by Tobias Reichmann, the Polish base player.
Drucks now on for Germany, back inside the Kuhn. Drucks trying to find some space. Kuhn has some space, and Kuhn finds the back of the net. So for the first time in 8 minutes, Germany find a goal. And the gap is now back up to 6 goals with 10 minutes to go in this bronze medal match at Rio 2016. Poland 20, Germany 26. And there's just going to be some court mopping to go on here.
You see how effective, look on the left side. The line player, Wiencheck, he's holding back two defenders to make the space. No wonder he's cheering. He did the hard work and left the door open for his teammate. Play resumes then. Last 10 minutes of the game, and time has now really, really run out for the Poles to sit back, and they've got to throw caution to the wind here and look to close this gap. Wiśniewski has come on. Bielecki back. But as ever, he's found himself on the wrong side. Wiśniewski desperately calling for the ball on the wing, but not getting it. And Strobel, who's playing as a makeshift left winger, doing his bit in defence as well. Ball back out again. And a 2 minute suspension may help Poland's cause. Strobel gives a rather surprised look to Vaclav Horacek, the referee, but unmoved. Strobel's moved, though. He's moved to the bench.
So here it is again. I think it was just that little off-the-ball push, wasn't it, that it's been given for? So Germany down to 6 players. But there's now just over 9 minutes to go, and really, Poland haven't made that much progress into Germany's lead for a while now. It was up a bit higher than this, but even in the second half, they have still conceded 2 more, and there's a good save from Wolf. Keeps the gap at 6, and Germany looking more and more likely to take this bronze medal.
That's a brilliant save. Huge keeper, though, 1.98 meters. Tries to lob him. All he had to do was down next to the standing leg, but it's so much easier when you're watching it than when you're on court facing. Huge goalkeeper coming straight at you. Ball's being sent back for the throw, and it's taken with a 6-goal lead. And Poland, we've got Sipsak back on again. He too with that shoulder injury, not fully fit. They've used him for just 24 minutes in the game. Kuss returning to the centre in defence as Lievski pushes up. They've got the power play, but Germany have responded by taking out the keeper. Reichmann is playing almost out as a makeshift right back if you need him to come in as Weinhold goes in. Drucks, free throw, is it? Nothing given. Lievski picks up the ball and goes for the empty goal. That's the danger, you put on the extra player, but we've seen it happen so often here in Rio. There's the steal, and it's Wiśniewski who gets it, and Lievski scores effectively from 34 metres.
So they get back down to 5 with 8 minutes left on the clock. Germany still down to six players, and again they've taken off the goalkeeper. Reichman. Little thought about the shot there. And there is the shot. Julius Kühn scores the goal, and the gap is back up to six. Receives it, runs across a couple of players, and fires it home.
What a season Kühn is having. So, Poland now with the 4-2 attack to create space. That works. Lijewski straight through, unopposed. And after a good spell to get three goals either side of half-time, he's been relatively quiet, but Sipsak playing as an extra line player alongside with Bartosz Jurecki. Gives a little bit of space, but the Germans are back to full strength again. And having pushed up a second defender, every now and again, while they had the power play, the Poles now drop back. It was Wisniewski. Well, he's going to try again. They've got to try something desperately now. The two back defenders coming out. Now the break is on. Cut through by Daszek. No mistake from him. Takes his time. And then shoots down next to the standing leg of Wolf. And only the second opportunity he's had to move up on a fast break. Wolf left to fend for himself.
So they gap down to four. Poland 23, Germany 27. Just edging back into it now. Out to Weinhold. Weinhold with a little cut inside and fires it well over, but the whistle had already gone. Weinhold fouled. It was Lijewski who stood his ground, got a whack on the neck on the way down as a reward. As Weinhold makes his way off. And it's going to be Fabian Vida who will come on to replace him. And there is Lijewski having a little bit of a remonstration with one of his teammates. Away now come Germany. Vida immediately trying to wriggle in, and very, very fortunate there, Germany, that the whistle went.
Foul at the back by Kuss, the defence specialist, with a bit of a shove. So Vida is on, number 10.
Oh! Oh! Absolutely misread, and there's... Oh, what a waste! What a waste for Poland!
Well, Kuss twice has found himself going up in attack, uncharted territory for the defender. He missed one shot and now he misses a clear pass. Looks like his mind was already on the shot before he'd actually got control of the ball. And that the 14th turnover for Poland in the game. And if he'd scored that, what a difference this could have been. So Vida waiting at the back there, the Fuchs Berlin right back, who scored 142 goals for them in the season. Brought down, he'll get the free throw. Takes off good height, but Kuss clatters into him, taking his arm in the process. Oh, yes! At the back, Wieńczek, the Kiel line player. Quick throw off is taken. We've got a trip, and are the referees going to say that was intentional? Well, they are. Eichmann is off. Takes his time going off, coming to terms with that. The clock's been stopped anyway, with just about 5 minutes remaining. Germany to be short-handed. Let's have a look and see. Well, they say he just crashed deliberately into Jaklewski.
Tough one to call. Shake of the head from the coach, Dagur Sigurdsson. He's not entirely in agreement. Poland 23, Germany 28. 5 minutes to go and five goals in it. And Germany down to six players. So now or never really for Poland. I've been saying for quite a few minutes now they've got to try and start to get back into it, but it's in the area. What a chance that was for Jaklewski.
Well, that's a real shame. It actually opened up quite a big angle, but Jaklewski judged to have touched down before he could put the ball in. And so Germany, while they're short-handed, take off the goalkeeper and put on the extra attacker. You wonder also with Poland whether at some point they're going to decide, right, well, we're that far behind with time running out, we've got to start attacking 5-2, just take out the keeper and try and overload the German defence. But they are beginning to look very tired, especially the big shooters, Lijewski, Bielecki, not really on song anymore in these latter stages of the bronze medal match, as Drucks is brought down and very happy to take his time. No point rushing when you've got this kind of lead in the closing stages. Look to pass to Wieńczek, but in the end wisely held the ball as Kuss was fouling him anyway. Shoved by Lijewski to boot as well.
There is Drucks. Germany still down to six for the next 67 seconds. The court is mopped, and we've just got 4 minutes on the clock now. Strobel inside the Reinhold. Vida looking for a gap, lofts it into Wiencheck. Oh, tried the little showman's float over the goalkeeper, but it was well read by Wisemirski. Now here come Poland, and it's fired in. No mistake this time from Michał Daszczyk. And Poland get the gap back to four with just under 4 minutes to go. They scored three in about a minute and 20 seconds earlier on.
It can happen. This is a great, I mean, he just jumped, well, too early, which saved him. He was down on the ground and able to backtrack before the lob went across. And there was the nice feed in by Lijewski and Daszczyk as ever. Round the keeper, four goals, and they've really got to push forward. The Germans still short-handed for another 20 seconds. Kuss pushing up deep. Oh, that was a bit dangerous. Ah, oh, Daszczyk, well, he apologises almost. Charged out to cut the pass. He was nowhere near it and backtracked desperately, but he'd given Gensheimer a huge space to score.
And now Poland trying to come forward, and they've lost possession. So that is absolutely vital. Jaklewski getting the turnover, and Germany back in control. And well, those two moments really, the goal for Germany and then Poland losing possession, could be the final nails in the coffin of their bronze medal hopes.
So after a really nice flowing first half, it's a bit more stop-start. It is late in the competition, the teams are tired as Wiencheck makes Poland's problems even bigger.
Six goals now, they need to get back. There's one of them fired in, but even you can see as Jurkiewicz gets back up, there's just no energy left in the Poland team. He almost has to haul himself back to his feet and slowly meanders back towards the centre line.
I mean, the Poles, of course, playing without the injured Michał Jurecki. Szyba came on briefly in the first half, couldn't really do anything. He's been off ever since, and they really are playing shorthand, whereas the Germans, all the back players, able to pull their weight when they come on. And at the moment, they're showing a lot of energy and they're pulling apart this tired Polish defence. And it's Wiencheck again, who's just sitting at the back and he's waiting for the back players to pull the defence one way, then the other. Strobel finding him on the line in acres of space. And I'm afraid now it's a bit of a rundown for the Germans.
Well, they failed to qualify for London 4 years ago, so every man in the squad is making their Olympic debut. And all of them, by the looks of it, are going to get an Olympic medal. Very impressive performances from Germany. This shows that victory in the European Championships, not just a blip.
Absolutely not. And Heiner Brandt joining the applause. No, I mean, they have one of the strongest leagues in the world, but of course a lot of foreign players playing there. And people always said, well, that doesn't allow the young German players to come through. Well, I think they proved the point that if you find the right players and mix them together, and Sigurdsson's done a great job with that, you can find the recipe. He tried to flick the ball back, but that came off a defender. He didn't know anything about it, but it's a chance now for them. And lofted over Daszczyk, the shortest player in the Polish team. But a terrible pass, and that sums up really the match for Poland, or at least the second half for Poland, with all those unforced errors.
Yeah, there was Lijewski trying to get that pass in, and the German team already celebrating on the touchline. Fetter's come on for a brief moment in these closing stages. In fact, there he is, number 23, out on the left-hand side there with the ball in his hands. And the Germans are applauding. The Germans are jumping on the touchline, because there's the final whistle. And Germany win bronze at Rio 2016. A side full of Olympic debutants have managed to overhaul Poland, who were looking to get their best Olympic result. But it finishes here in the men's handball bronze medal match. Poland 25, Germany third place with 31. Still the French making all the noise though. But the bronze medalists, you can see a couple of German flags fluttering in the crowd. And it is Germany who stand on to the third step. They winning the bronze medal match, and a lot of those players naturally, absolutely elated. They got a gold in Berlin. There is Miss Yomilka Ruiz-Luas handing out the medals, but they got a gold in Berlin way back in 1936, a silver in Athens in 2004. But for the majority of these players, in fact, for all of these players, this is their Olympic debut and their first Olympic medal.
Very big moment indeed for them. Vienček there, who did so well. And quite a few of these players, of course, a year ago would not even have been thinking about being in the Olympic team and then got their call up for the European Championship with that sea of injuries. And suddenly, here they are, Tobias Reichmann, who just picked his up. Very much one of them. So, Heine Vetter, the goalkeeper. He came on and made some key saves at the right moment, although didn't play that much in the game in the end. Tall figure of Hendrik Pekeler, 2 meters and three, the playmaker. He was in the European Championship winning squad. Beinhold, who scored three in the match, the Kiel right back.
Martin Strubel. There is Martin Strubel. And he and Beinhold were late additions to the squad, brought in because of injury to other players, as was Stefan Fett, who didn't really play much in that bronze medal match at all, just came on the end for a little bit. Then Andreas Wolf, the next man to get his medal there, as he has a little bit of a joke, and Wolf with a save percentage of 34% in that bronze medal match, and he picked up some goals as well, Andreas Wolf. I think he picked up five over the course of the tournament. And then at the end there, Paul Drucks, a very exciting young talent. In fact, Kuhn and Drucks at the end there, 23 and 21 years old, respectively. Real talents for the future for Germany, as well as clearly being talents for now.
So stepping up, Per Bertelsen, IHF COC caretaker chairman. Well, he's a very happy man, but he's trying to hide it at the moment. The Dane, he's going to go over and hand the medals to the Germans. A wry smile as he gets there, or rather the little token gifts that they all get. It's a replica of the logo from the tournament. There you go, if you were wondering what it is. And he will follow down the route of the same players. And 10 of them won gold at the European Championships last year. Well, earlier this year, rather, to dispossess the French of their first title. The Danes have just dispossessed them of their second. Very exciting team, the Germans. Very young team. We're saying some of them as young as 21, Drucks. 22 for Wieder. 23 for Kuhn. And a huge talent, Kuhn, with four goals in the in this match, but also eight in the semi-final to get them through. Wolf, the goalkeeper, just 25. Another one of the beneficiaries of the European Championships, who played out of his socks in that tournament. And Drucks, who missed the European Championship but still now gets on the podium with Germany.
So there are the bronze medalists in Rio 2016 in the men's handball competition. Germany winning the bronze medal match, defeating Poland, and they are on the third step of the podium. Now on to the silver medalists over there on the left-hand side. It's silver for France, runners-up in the final. And we'll speak about the team in a second, but the fans, the French fans, I would suggest, maybe apart from Brazil, the hosts, have been the best in the tournament.
They've been absolutely fantastic. And quite bloody the turnaround straight away to thank them. There's Gribi, you so sadly missed out on the final through injury. And Mr. Tony Estanguet, the French member. The IOC steps up to hand the medals to his fellow countryman Nyokas at the end there, who came on as a replacement for the injured Gribi. Barely got on court, but did enough. He is an Olympian, come what may. Let no one take that away from you. Narcisse, who scored four, but so tired at the end. Girard, who came on for a brief spell. And of course, Nicolas Karabatic, five goals, but had to go off for 10 minutes after taking picking up an injury, and it was a real turning point.
And even as he leant down to receive the medal, he sort of did it in stages. It's been a tough tournament, this, for Karabatic, after a tough season for a lot of these players.
Indeed.
Maybe. Well, we'll see plenty more of him, the 24-year-old from Montpellier. Scored 9 in the competition, still trying to find his range. And, of course, Thierry Omeyer, who at 39, this may very well be the last time we see him on the Olympic stage, at least as a player. What an incredible play, and chance of TT from the crowd, his nickname. Abalou, the artist. 31 years of age, 691 goals for France in 210 appearances. And Sorrendo, the Barcelona line player, has got to go back with his teammate, Nudisbo, who's going to step on and collect his gold, and he'll have the bragging rights.
Guigou there scored some vital goals, a little less effective in the latter stages, but was a real strong strength for France in the group part of the tournament. And then some of the younger players, Fabregas, Dipanda, and of course, at the end, Valentin Porte. All relatively inexperienced, Porte a little more so than the other two, but Fabregas in particular, just 20 years of age. There is Thierry Omeyer, who has 2 golds to go with that silver.
So Miguel Rocamas, the first vice president of the International Handball Federation, steps up and hands out the little mementos to the players. France, who started the year as European, World and Olympic champions, they lost the European title to the Germans. Now they've lost the Olympic title to Denmark, but they will be hosting the World Championships in January, and will very much be hoping to hang on to that title. They have the only team to have been 3 times European, World and Olympic champions. That's not going to happen for a while now, obviously, because that's the whole point about these Olympics. You have European every 2 years. In every intervening year, it's going to be the World Championships, but these come every 4 years, hence they mean so much.
So are those championships in January, is that going to be the last hurrah for your Omeyers, for your Narcisse, that on home soil? We're going to see a very different side in Tokyo.
I think it'll be a completely different side in Tokyo. But the good news for France, of course, is that they're currently under-19, under-21 world champions, under-17 European champions. There is clearly a good program to bring through great players, as we've seen here, the likes of Dipanda, Fabregas, Nguessan, Grebi. And they will be there for the future. Nicolas Karabatic there, 32. Well, he could do another Olympics.
But it's France who are the silver medalists in the men's handball at Rio 2016. Defeated in the final. But Denmark don't wait for the announcements to finish. They cannot wait to get onto the top step. The biggest day in the history of Danish men's handball. They've won European championships before, as Gunilla Lindberg, the IOC member of Sweden, will hand out the medals. They've won European championships. They've been in world championship finals. But for the first time, it's Olympic gold medals for Denmark. Starting off with Niklas Landin, the goalkeeper. Mads Christiansen wasn't on the court that much in the final in the end. It was predominantly Sonnegaard that played in that right-back position. Mads Mensah Larsen. What a special day this is for all of these players.
An incredible day. Kasper Mortensen, the winger, their only left winger. He certainly carried the load. 25 goals in total, and this four on a knee. He'll go back to Barcelona.
This is the problem with handball teams. They've got a bit of height to them, haven't they?
Yes, they certainly have. They're having to crouch down a long way. Sven, who was utterly brilliant in these games. 48 goals for Denmark. And René Toft, who together with his brother Henrik Toft, a little further down the line, who was superb in defence, but also playing well in the attack. And Henrik Mølgaard, another one of the defence specialists, will go back to play, of course, at his club in Paris, PSG, with a beaming smile.
And maybe the medal around his neck on the first day back.
Well, it depends how well he wants to be received by the crowd. No, they won't take that away from him. They thoroughly deserved it. There is the other top brother, Henrik, who plays for Flensburg in Germany. And still trying to come to terms with it. You're going to have trouble wiping that smile off their face. And the big man himself, Mikkel Hansen, a huge roar from the crowd. His 54 goals in this Olympic run. He's been top scorer in the French League this year, top scorer in the European Champions League, and now he is an Olympic champion to boot. And Olsen, in his first major competition for Denmark, what a story for the 31-year-old who played such a huge part in the game. And Damgaard, who did so well in these Olympics but didn't come on in the final. He could have been an option if the French had started individual defence earlier. But in the end, he still has that special moment. Dr. Hassan Mustafa, then the president of the International Handball Federation, will present the mementos. So after three defeats in finals, two of them rather painful memories for them, they have laid all the ghosts to rest, and Denmark have taken a major title, and one they can keep for 4 years. It's the special one. They are the Olympic champions. Mensa Larsen plays for Rhein Neckar Löwen. So many of them do actually play their club handball in Germany. Twice European champions. World title has eluded them, as has the Olympics. But now, finally, they are on the highest step of the podium. And a bright future as well, because their youth teams are coming through as well, the Danes. They're always there or thereabouts in the under-21s, the under-20s. And they're another one who produce some great new players to come through. This current team averaging about 29 and a half years of age on average. So maybe, unlike the French, less of the young blood coming into this team yet. But they are all there, and they are knocking on the door of these players, and the final two there. Olsen and Damgaard.
So it's Denmark who win gold at Rio 2016 in the men's handball. They defeat France, the defending champions, 28-26 in the final. Denmark Olympic champions. And as recognition of that, they stand on the top step and listen to the national anthem of Denmark.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Dinamarca.
Such a special moment for Danish handball. Such a special moment for all of those players. And they are the Olympic champions. It's silver for France and it's bronze for Germany at the end of an incredibly competitive 2 weeks of handball here at the Future Arena at Rio 2016. And the Germans first off to congratulate the winners, and that is a moment you'll want to record for posterity, as Denmark are the victors. A really strong team, a really strong performance, and what a day for those Danish fans to come and watch on. From about 10 minutes left in the match, some of them just couldn't bear to look. And there's a conversation right at the end there with Weinhold and Nicholas Landin. 9 of the Danish team play in Germany. That's why we saw an awful lot of conversation between the individual Danish and German players, and there Mikkel Hansen, now an Olympic champion, to add to his World Player of the Year titles, to add to his French Player of the Year titles, and a gold medal to go with it. And there are the French high-fiving with the Danish squad in a hard-fought match, and I think the French will accept the Danes as the champions.